Let's go ahead and do example two now. So picking up in our formula for surface area, we're going to just jump right in. So find the surface area of the surface formed by revolving the line segment y equals 1 minus x about the y-axis when y is going from 0 to 1. Now, let's draw this one because I want you to see what's happening here. And the reason why is we actually have to change this to be in terms of y this time around. So we're going to have a dy here in the back. So if I think about my line that I'm told that's going to get rotated or revolved, it's the line y equals 1 minus x. So if I plug in 0, x is 1. Okay. Sorry, if I plug in 0 for x, y is 1. So right over here. If I plug in 1 for x, y is 0. So I'll say it's about right there. Okay, so 1 for y, 1 for x. And it's a line, but it's just a line segment. Okay, and it's just this line segment because I'm told we need to go from y is 0 to 1, and down here y is 0, and up there y is 1. So my segment, I'm told, is revolving around the y-axis. So we're rotating around this way. And so you're actually, when you do this in three dimensions, you get this like cone type shape. Not the best drawing, but this cone like this. Pretty bad drawing, but hopefully you can visualize it. This is in the background. So this would be like if we could see through the cone. All right, so what is this surface area? What is this area that would be on the outside of this cone? Okay, not to include like the base or anything. It's hollow in the inside. Now, we have to find y. In this case, it's not necessarily going to be y, and you'll see why. This represented the radius. Okay, and then we also need to find the derivative of our function. So let's start with the radius. So the radius, if I start to take strips out of this surface or bands, let me just draw one for you so you can see what the radius is going to be. So if I were to like cut out a band from this surface, and let's just go like that, okay? Well, the radius would be coming from the y-axis and going out this way horizontally, okay? So whatever this number is, and depending on where I kind of cut this band out from, the radius is changing. So like, let's say I cut out a band of my surface lower, then the radius would have been bigger. If I sliced a band higher, I would have had a smaller radius. But notice what the radius is in terms of. It's actually an x value, okay? So our radius, we need to figure out what it is with an x. So we do know what y in terms of x is, so we just need to re-evaluate this with an x. From here, the fact that y was 1 minus x, which is this blue line that we were revolving, so this blue line was y equals 1 minus x. Well, the question just becomes, well, what is x? Okay, so really quick steps, just add x to both sides and subtract y. So x equals 1 minus y. So we just rewrote this line in terms of x, and then that's going to tell us our radius based on our different y values. So somewhere along this y-axis, we could pick a y value and we can know its corresponding x value. So that's going to represent our radius. So that's one thing we needed. I'm going to go ahead and box that in. And then the next thing we need is the derivative. So in this case, since we just changed the way we're thinking about our function from this original formula, our derivative is actually going to be the derivative of x with respect to y. So you would say f prime, but this time it's like f of y prime. And so derivative here, let's differentiate from this version, derivative of x with respect to y is just going to be negative 1. So negative 1, okay? And that's going to get plugged into our formula here. So let's box that in as well. So going back to our surface area integral, the surface area is the integral. In this case, our a to b, you can kind of call it a different letter if you want, maybe c to d, is our y values. So from y goes from 1 until y equals, from 0 until 1. And then we have 2 pi, our radius, in terms of x was 1, when we solve for x is 1 minus y. And then times our square root of 1 plus our derivative squared, and our derivative was negative 1. And because we're focusing on y, we revolved around the y-axis, this is dy. Okay, and now we have our setup. So the more challenging part is the setup. From here, the integration is not going to be so bad. So we're just going to simplify this. Okay, this is what we get when we simplify. So the square root part became a 2. We went ahead and factored that out along with the 2 pi. And we were just left with 1 minus y inside our integrand. And so let's go ahead and integrate this real fast. Not going to be a bad one. This is just going to be, I'm going to kind of leave this factor out front. This is y, integral of 1 is y, minus integral of y is y squared over 2. And we'll evaluate that from 0 to 1. Okay, so I'm going to leave this 2 square root 2 pi factored out. Alright, and we get 1 minus, let's do this in parts, 1 minus 1 squared over 2 minus 0 minus 0 squared over 2. Okay, and then this becomes 0. This is 1 minus 1/2. So this is just going to be 1/2. So this is 2 square root 2 pi times 1/2. Final answer, 2 square root 2 times pi. All right, we did it.